my name is Kelly Goff. I'm a blogger, author, political analyst, and contributing editor for theloop21.com and regular contributor to the Huffington Post, and I'm the author of the new novel, The GQ Candidate. The GQ Candidate is the story of what happens to a group of friends when one of them decides to run for president. By sheer coincidence, the candidate is a handsome, charismatic, African-American elected official in his 40s. Sound familiar? In this case, his name is Governor Luke Cooper, and he has been raised by two Jewish parents, and the issue of his racial identity and his religious identity and his faith all play a key role in some of the drama that ends up enveloping his presidential campaign, along with a couple of scandalous surprises that tended to pop up involving his group of friends, his friends from law school, his friends from college. And the book is really about the impact that campaigns have on those closest to the candidate. A story that actually hasn't been told. There have been so many phenomenal books on campaigns, the primary colors probably being the most famous. There's actually never been a book that's specifically about how a campaign impacts the lives of those closest to a candidate, and that's a story I was really interested in telling. Interesting because I never knew I would become a novelist, and my first book, Party Crashing, How the Hip Hop Generation Declared Political Independence, came out in 2008, and it was time for me to do my next book, and I had a couple of ideas, but none that I was particularly passionate about, and I remember I said to my agent, I have this kind of wacky idea about what happens to a group of friends when one of them decides to run for president, but it's fiction, and I've never done fiction before, and I don't know if I can do fiction, and she said, I love the idea, you've absolutely got to do it, start writing. And so that's actually how I became a novelist. It's sort of by accident. Canada is handsome and African-American and charismatic, and he has, you know, a knockout wife who's a bit of a fashionista. But, you know, what I really do believe, though, is a couple years ago, if I tried to do this book, right, my agent and I both said we would have been laughed out of the office of every major publisher in America if we had said, Kelly has this great idea for a novel about what happens to a group of friends when one of them runs for president. He has a great shot of winning. Oh, by the way, he's black. It would have been deemed completely unbelievable. And now, thanks to President Obama, it's not so unbelievable anymore. And so my hope is that a couple years from now, that when someone picks up a book like this, they may think it's based on President Barack Obama, but just like if you pick up any other book on a campaign, you don't assume it's based on the last white president that was sitting in the White House. My hope is one day someone will pick up a book like this a few years from now, and they won't just automatically assume it's based on President Barack Obama, because there will have been plenty of candidates of color, and it just won't seem like he's the only one anymore. Someone in the White House does have a copy. I do know that, actually.